Welcome, guys. Back to Project Cars 2 Career. I started yesterday Formula Rookie. Went through the first of a few races within the Asian Championship. Sakita Sprint is the second race, and I'll be doing it today. Practice, qualifying, and race. 8 laps race, 30 minutes practice, 50 minutes qualifying. Settings as with the first race and with the kart, I'll be trying to stay at the 100% or just 100 point skill level, 100 opponent aggression, and I will allow restarts due to different reasons and sometimes unpredictable AI, as I found out yesterday. Okay, let's start. I've done a few laps already. That was just to learn the car-truck combination. I set the tire pressure. Not perfect. Rookie race, that's the setup. I actually wanted to edit it a little bit before the race. It's asymmetrical due to different tire temperatures, and on this track the coldest tire is the rear right, so let's try to reduce the pressure a little bit more on this one. What else do we have here? I'm going to reduce this one a little bit because they were still quite cold yesterday. Whatever the reason, let's just save it. Okay, let's give it a try. Oops, I forgot to put my gloves on. I have no idea what times to expect from the AI. A few laps I did yesterday were just a private session. I'm really not prepared. I've just realized I forgot to start my dashboard. Here we go. It's up and running now. part risky. I probably should avoid this funny curbs. The third lap and I'm getting the tires up to the 10th. It's still not there yet. But I'm working towards a good green, let's call it, temperatures. What I'm more worried about than tires temperature is brakes. They cold all around. Oh. But that particular car or formula doesn't have any adjustable settings for the brake ducts, which means I'm stuck with what I have here. And all four are cold at the moment. Even after this braking, and I think this is the strongest braking on all of the truck, it's still cold. I mean, they're picking the temperature, but so slowly that I think they won't be able to pick up a green temperatures before the end of the race, which is just 8 laps. Seconds. This turn is killing the FFB. A force feedback is so strong here. Oh wow, I missed the truck completely. Don't know how that happened. I need to speed up. I'm the slowest of all of them. And by a huge margin of 2 seconds. In comparison to the first one. I'm almost a second slower than the last one of the AI drivers. Such a mistake. I guess I'm trying too hard. I think it would be good to pick up one of them, drive behind one of the drivers to see where they are particularly faster than I am. Extra points for those cones. So I think I'm trying to be a bit too fast here. I'm almost out of fuel as well. That's the A flap. So I'm clearly set up for a race. But with these times, or with those times, shouldn't count on a good result, should I? 128.4. Just 0.3 of a second slower than the worst of I, and with mistakes like this one.
Roger that, pit now, we'll be ready when you are.
Where's the pit entry? Oh, I guess it's here. Where's the speed limiter? Was it at the front? I guess I missed it. The tires are warm up, so I didn't change the change them. Just need to refuel. That would be it. Okay, let's review those times. 28.4 I had, wasn't even counted. 2 seconds, 2.4 seconds, that's crazy. I'm 1.6 seconds slower in the first sector. I'm faster in the second. And I'm much slower, and a second slower in the third. That chicane probably is where they're gaining so much, and I'm losing so much. First sector. Interesting. Cold tires again, unfortunately, after that pit stop. Well, I'm sure there was one behind me. I don't think I can go any faster here. Seems like that's the limit. 28.8. not a bit faster, really. Should I be going here without even lifting? Is it possible? Probably should try. Well, I'm not brave enough to do it here. But I think I'm catching the guy in front. Twenty-seven point seven. So I improved finally. They're doing 26 now, they'll be doing 25 or 24 in the qualification. Which means my result will be even worse than it was in the first race when I was starting for the 9th position. I managed to win, as the AI was actually much slower in the race, or at least in the first stages of the race, in comparison to the qualification. But then, they picked up the speed and I wasn't really able to shake them off. After overtaking all of them. It's impossible to go here without lifting. So that puts me 9. I was 9th. I was 9th in the last race qualification session. 26.5 versus 27.7. So 25. I haven't really improved in the first sector. 25.5 versus 23.9. Still 1.5 second just in the first sector alone. I'm considerably faster in the second sector, not that much slower in the third one. So the first sector has to be the first turn. Can I see how they're driving that? On out lap or in lap. Seriously, AI has different rules for physics in these games. Thank you. I'm assuming the green around the tires means they got a perfect temperature. It's pretty much impossible on that car. Or maybe I'm doing something wrong with the setup, but I won't be setting up the car for 8 laps. That's crazy. I don't understand it. They don't look fast at all. But these times are outworldly. 4 minutes. Yeah, let's just skip to the end. I don't feel like driving more. And I just try the qualification. We'll be driving 100% or 100 and 100 and see how it goes. Oh, that's my teammate. Let's see, he was third in the last race. So he seems to be a quick guy. So I want to see how I'm going to compare to him. I shouldn't follow him, I should just drive the way I drive this turns. Those tires are so cold. But he's definitely not driving cleanly. And at this stage, he's actually slower than I am. Oh, they're cutting it hard here. It was actually good to drive behind him, just to see that. Definitely know that I'm losing a lot in this first corner. And in the SS, I guess. So I'll be trying to catch up in the sector 2. Sliding like crazy. They're driving like on rails in comparison. Oh, it looks like I'm cutting too much in comparison to him. Both laps invalidated. That's horrible. Cannot warm up the tires quickly enough. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's raining. Great. I'm going to restart this session. It's raining and I haven't done a clean lap yet.
Focus on this lap, mate. Let's make it count.
That car is sliding like crazy. Well, the tire temperature below 60 degrees, I'm not surprised, on slicks. This curve's getting slippery. Thank you. I don't have to race him during the qualification. Great. That's end of it for me. Ninth, like last time. Great. 26.9. Surprisingly, they slower than while it's raining. I guess that's the reason. I'm going to return to pit box after such an accident. I wouldn't be able to drive anymore. Just have to wait. 9:40. In Project Cars 1, when one skipped to the end or accelerated the time, a weird thing started happening with the AI when they were getting otherworldly times, impossible to achieve in any other way. So I don't really want to use it. I think driving doesn't make any sense. It's raining now. No one's going to improve. I'm 10th. That's similar to what I had in the first race. I'll try to just skip to the end and see what happens. Oh, looks like they fixed that bug. That's good. I stayed on 10th. Let's continue to the race and let's see if we can recover. Light rain. I'm just going to change the tires. Wet. Okay, I'm going to have a tire pressure. How low can I go? Oh wow. You know what? I'm going to try it. See what happens. I have nothing to lose. I want to see. I've never tried it in Project Cars 2. Go as low as the tire pressure. I want to see how that impacts the temperature gain. I think the default was 1.15 and 125 at the front, 115 at the back. So I went really, really low in comparison. I'm going to save it, but I'm going to save it to the new slot. I add some more. Yeah, I can. Okay. Continue. Hey, let's see. Let's see how it goes. I don't know breaking points in that weather. I guess I want to avoid all the curbs in wet. In real life they would be really slippery. Oh. Should I try to attack here? It's a fast turn. I'll wait it out. No point risking it. I was saying something about avoiding curbs. Thank you.
to fourth place. Keep pushing. You'll catch the leaders. They're not far away.
Not bad. I was 10th at the start of this race. I would still have 7 laps to go. Oh man! I guess he was sliding, that was his fault really. But he definitely left a space there, which I was more than happy to use. I have to remember they go really outside here, because I'm losing a slipstream. I think I have enough to overtake him before the first turn.
Good job, that's P2, keep it up.
I won't be risking overtaking this one. I still have 6 laps. And they seem to be quite slow in the wet. Maybe the rain is working with me rather than against me.
Throw for weakness, let him feel your presence.
So, driving over the curbs, on wet, in project cars, is actually quite manageable in comparison to real life. Is the weather getting better? It seems to be lighter now. Brighter, it's probably a better word here. My tires are completely cold, but that's probably because of the weather. My front brakes are keeping a good temperature now. It's staying above 300.
Fastest first sector you've done yet. Great job.
Whoa. That's a dangerous spot there. Oh, that's my teammate, I just realized. That's 1-2 for us. Oh. I guess that was a bit too brave. Oh, there's a lot of water staying there on this corner. Let's switch on that rear light. I guess I don't know. Okay, let's try to cut some chips in. We're half through the race. Now, I may be able to do it. I can finally see something.
You're up to first place, great job. Keep
That's
pushing.
A plus. The question is, can I escape? Oh, they're racing over the second now. I hope my guy can keep it. Defend it. Yeah, I think he was able to keep the second place for himself. Well, hopefully I can escape a little bit. It's half a second at the moment. Definitely more than what he had. Ah, there's a water staying there. I really have to avoid that corner, the inside of that corner. That right-hander became really dangerous. .8. I'm curious if they can catch up Slipstream from the distance.
You're leading by 1 second. Try and extend the gap, you can.
I'll be losing gap here. Yeah, 0.4. But I won't be risking it in that corner. Not while I'm leading. Whoa, that's aqua planning there. Oh, what have I done? What have I done? It was such a cool race to the point. Well, I'm going to restart. I enjoyed it. I know I can win it. If only I can avoid mistakes like that. Let's try again. That was horrible. Restart session. Yes, start. That was a good start. At least that. That's a few position gain. Just at the launch. I won't be waiting for him. Oh, thank you very much, mate. Seems like some parts of the track are more flooded than the others. Oh, they're braking here quite substantially. Let's grab that slipstream. Oh yes, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's a position gained. I better put lights on. It's getting I think that switches on the rear light, the rain light. I don't think this is the best place to try to overtake. Oh, there's a bit of aquaplaning there. We will probably see some puddles by the end of this race. That's my teammate. So we're going quite strong as a team. 1-2 at the moment. Can I use the slipstream to change it to swap the positions with him? Okay. That was good.
Awesome in the first sector, that's your best split so far.
Lock my wheels here. Oh, there is some water staying in the inside of the turn. What is interesting, and I'm seeing a few races live in the wet, and one recently at Statterton here, British GT3. And Ginettas and GT4s, basically GT cars. Seeing that in TV as well. In the wet, the drivers usually avoid curves. They become super slippery. I don't see that in a project cars too. I've been on a few curves in the wet, and it didn't feel too dangerous. Maybe I just wasn't driving a car, which is particularly influenced by those curves in the wet, I don't know. Have a second advantage over a second. So I'm not really running away from them, or like keeping the distance, which is quite strange. It's the same thing that happened in the first race, where I was able to overtake them, and then they suddenly accelerated and were able to keep my pace, which overall wouldn't surprise me because they were much faster in the practice session and in qualifications. That was a bit risky, but it was fun. Keeping that car sliding in the wet. That's half of the race here. 4 more laps to go. 0.8. I had much better exit from the last chicane. This is when I'm losing time. Yeah, I lost 0.3 seconds here, and I've been losing here during the qualifications as well, and practice. Ah, we've got a puddle here, I need to be really careful there. Another one here. There's a lot of water here, I don't want to get over it. This is where I'm gaining. Even though I'm driving really slowly here due to these puddles, I'm back to 0.8, while I was at 0.35 or something like that. One second almost. It actually is 1 second. 2 laps to go. I'm avoiding the inside here. There is some water there. There was water there, if I remember correctly, yeah. Not driving over it. It's super fast in the turns, but then suddenly they're losing everything here. It dropped to like below 0.3 and I'm on a 1 second again. There's the water again, let's avoid it. Yeah, more water here. .35, almost 1.4. More and more puddles, water all over the place. .8 seconds, 2 laps to go. Keep it on the black and we'll get there. I actually didn't lose that much this time. That's a bonus. That's a bloody puddle. A huge one. Good. It's good I had such an advantage. It was totally unexpected. I mean, I knew it was there, but the reaction of the car was out of nowhere. Not sure what to expect in the next and the final lap. That was a scary moment. I have been all. I won't have the same advantage now. 1.2 rather than
1.8. I mean,
0.9, more or less, it's growing. I think all the water is on the... Yeah, I will try to go... Okay, that was good. But they gained so much. How do they go so quickly over the puddle? Jesus, that's crazy. Almost like AI is not affected by that at all. Feel like Norris that last race in Sochi. I'm first and I'm kinda the first one to hit all those puddles and surprises all over the track. But I think I'm safe now. 1.6 seconds. Uh-huh. 1.8 seconds. And here we are. Oh yeah, that was a clean win. It was a fun race. I actually like racing in the rain in Project Cross 2. Such an interesting experience. A lot of fun. It requires a lot of concentration. It's surprising all over the track. The conditions are changing. Here we go, that's the puddle. Even at such a low speed. Just in time. Oh, here, okay.
Well done, mate. You won the race. You really, really earned it today. Great job.
Actually, it was 2.2 seconds. Okay. That was a cool race. Where's my guy? Oh, it's fifth. Man, he was first. I thought he was going to stay on second. Oh well, it was an easy race, I guess, for him and for me. He got 20. Hopefully we can stay on first as a team. Yeah, by 1 point. Oh. Okay. Fastest lap, Lei Liu, so there's a third guy. 136. I'm curious what was my fastest lap. His was 136.9. So it's 0.118. 118th of a thousandth. Okay, that's good, that's good. Happy with that. 3 points for me, 106 for a team. Okay, so that's much better. 15 points difference. That's good. Okay, that was Project Cars Career for today. I'm just going to check what is the next race in that in the Asia Championship. It is Dubai Autodrome Club. Okay, good news is I know the track, not necessarily from this game. So I'll do an offline practice again. And we'll see how it goes. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you next time.